Hey, it's Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida. Welcome to where? The Christmas Room, of course.
Sit back, relax. You are about to watch a Peter Gregg video. Something warm, human, and wonderful happens when you watch Peter Gregg.
Hey, 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 hey. Thank you for being here. Welcome, welcome, welcome. I appreciate it. I appreciate it. I appreciate it. So let's see, what do we got going today? I've been getting more questions than normal, so I figured it might be a good topic. What is the difference between the Canon dual pixel autofocus, the Sony autofocus, and whatever other autofocus we have out there? So what do I have over here? Let me step out of the frame real quick. Let me grab this. I just got this in. This is a Sony A6400, so guess what we're going to be talking about in the next few videos. Go ahead, guess. It's the Sony 6400. And just as unique is this lens. It's a 16mm Sigma 1.4 lens. Boy, if it had image stabilization, talk about the ultimate vlogging setup. It's just amazing. Anyway, stop. I want to stay on track. What do we got going here? What is Canon's dual pixel autofocus? Do I have a Canon here? Yes, I do, although this is quite an old one. It might not have dual pixel autofocus. Dual pixel autofocus is dual pixel autofocus. All right, so what's the difference between the Sony autofocus and the Canon autofocus? And we'll even throw in a couple of extra ones. All right, on the Sony one, which is what you're watching right now, is the A7 Mark III camera with a 50mm 1.4 lens at 1.4. And we're shooting 24p. And I'm not recording it in the camera, I'm recording it outside the camera. You see how I did that? This is in the camera. This means outside the camera. So when I do this, that means it's inside the camera. When I do that, that means it's outside the camera. I don't know what's wrong with me tonight. It must have been, I didn't eat a chocolate bar. I've been doing well and starting to lose weight again. So for those of you guys that are regulars here, welcome. I love you guys. Thank you for staying with me. We are over 30 something thousand subscribers now. So that is important. So please subscribe. People are telling me I don't ask often enough. All right, Canon, dual pixel autofocus. On your sensor, there is pixels. On those pixels is something called photodiodes. This is across the board. Every camera that you can hold up, every camera that you can use, any camera that's digital that you can look at has photodiodes. So now, Canon is playing games with the photodiodes and it becomes quite interesting. So what Canon has done is, let's pick 10 million pixels, all right? I'm only going to use that for pretend. So I don't want people writing me and saying, who in the world would use a 10 megapixel camera? Megapixel. I mean, do I speak English? Sometimes I do. All right, so they put all those photodiodes that's in there that actually senses the light, and they cut them in half. There's a left side and a right side, okay? This will mean left because it's my left, although you'll be looking at it that way, and this will be right. So this means I'm recording outside the camera, and this means I'm recording inside the camera. No, it was like this. Inside, outside, left, right. Okay, so we got to have these down so this way you can understand what I'm talking about. All right, so they divide them in half. And that means that every single pixel is capable of doing two things. And that's why it's called dual pixel autofocus. So what happens is they use it for focusing. There was a camera years ago called a rangefinder focus system. As a matter of fact, this camera right here uses a rangefinder focus system. This is a stereo camera. There's three lenses on this camera. One lens is for the one half of the image. The other lens is for the other half of the image. It's film and it's stereo. When they put them together, you look at it through a viewer, okay? And you could see, and it looks like, you know, those movies that you can reach out and touch. So the center one is for when you look through the hole down here and you can see, I can see you. You look good today. All right. So in order to focus, you turn the focus wheel left and right, and the image is kind of like cut in half. you know, and when it goes together, it's in focus. Okay, so when these two fingers touch, it's in focus. When these two fingers are not touching, it's not in focus. So many signs in today's, this is left, this is right. This is I'm recording in the camera, this is I'm recording outside in an external recorder. It's the Ninja 5, by the way. All right, so what they do is they can tell which way to move a lens. So for instance, when you focus a lens, okay, this is zooming it, but the other ring focuses it and it turns it so that it comes into focus. So when you turn it and move all that glass that's in that lens, it's pulling it down or out, and it can tell right away which way this the focus is. If it's down like this, which way do I have to go up? This is a test, okay? Let's see if you pass. If my hand is like this, it's got to go up to focus. If my hand is like this, it's got to go down to focus. All right, so a phase detect system can tell which way the camera should move the lens to focus. All right, so now it gets it very close, but in general focus systems, it only gets it so close. So it has to revert to adding contrast detect autofocus. I want that to fall off. Okay, so that's why the Sony is called a hybrid. So it uses phase detect to get really close and then uses contrast detect to finally bring it into focus. But it all happens really fast. Panasonic only uses contrast detection. So Canon only uses phase detection because they took and split the pixels. So what is unique about dual pixel autofocus? What's unique about the dual pixel autofocus is this. This means this. So left, right, recording in camera, recording in the Ninja, and this means this. Okay, I'm gonna be so confused by the end of this video. All right, so phase detection only turns the pixels on for autofocus for the ones that it needs, which means all the rest of the pixels that would be recording this particular video, the movie that I'm making for you right now, would, if it was a Canon camera, they would all be solid. They would all be receiving light. Now, if it's the Sony, those sensors don't do double duty. So like my camera's got 400 plus focus spots embedded, bing, 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 into the sensor, which means those spots are not receiving light. They're not light sensitive. They are for the purpose of the camera to use its internal computer to focus. Now, the Canon, all the pixels don't do that on the Canon sensor, if I can get my head together. All right, what the pixels all do is they're all set up to be in light gathering mode. When the camera tells it, hey, we've recognized the face, turn on the phase detection, turn on the autofocus right around that box, boom. Those only switch over to doing focus ability, all right? And then if I move my head over here, or if I move my head over here, all right, the box that's around my head, you've seen it, you know, when you do focus, you can see there's a box around your head. Some of them will put a crosshair over the closest eye, so it would be over this eye. It would be over this eye now because it depends on which eye is the closest. So what happens is all the sensors, all the photodiodes on the Canon is actually receiving light. And this is contrary to Sony, where all the photodiodes, except the ones that they have embedded to be focus diodes, are receiving light. So the Sony is more likely, I'm not saying it will, but it's more likely to show banding, because years ago, what we did with the older cameras, and I do have an older camera, is you might have some dead pixels, which would be kind of like those focus pixels that are in the phase detection. They put them all around. Fuji has it, Olympus has it, Sony has it, who else? Whoever else has it, all except Canon. All right, so what you do is you put the cap on here and you have it map your sensor. So it takes out the dead pixels. So what does it do with those dead spots? All the pixels around, the software makes up what should be in that pixel. All right, that's what's happening with the Sony. the Sony Hybrid Focusing System. They've got, on my camera, they've got over 400 plus, I don't remember the number, otherwise I'd spit it right out, focus sensor photo diodes in there. Those do not receive and absorb light. What they do is they cause the camera, through the computer power of the camera, to focus, which is what I'm doing now. So if I walk over here to Jingle Bell's spot and tap on his blanket, which is what I do when I come in the room, I do a double tap there, and then I come and say welcome. Okay, so what it's following my face at that time, or my body, are those sensors alone on the Canon system are receiving information for focus. On the Sony system, all the sensors on the whole cotton picking sensor is receiving information for focus. So that's basically the difference. So now you've got Panasonic coming along, and they've got their DFD, and I don't have a Panasonic here, it's in my office, like the S1. There is no photoreceptors on it at all, photodiodes that are performing autofocus and not receiving light. So Panasonic is able to come to say, we have the best image quality. There is no cutting of our pixels in half. We don't have embedded focus images. So they're digging their heels in, and they're driving hard to try to get DFD, distance to defocus, to work, because that is basically replacing the phase detection part of the focus system. So when you have a Panasonic camera, there's no pixels that have been downgraded to not receive light. So they're all receiving light. So they can claim, we give a better picture. There's much less banding. I'm not saying there isn't any, because I'm sure somebody will do a test and go like, oh, there's banding over here. All right, so that's what Panasonic's strong point is. Although Panasonic has filed a patent for a dual pixel autofocus type system. It's a public knowledge. It's on Micro Four Thirds rumors.com, which is 43rumors.com. I saw it there. And then if you just do a Google search, Panasonic has, sure enough, and so has Nikon. They have filed patents for dual pixel autofocus type systems, which means they're not like the Sony, which is a mix of the phase detection and the contrast detection. So on my Sony, what it's doing, and why you see just a hair of pulsing, it's so small, you almost can't tell it's there. So what it does is it uses the phase detect. I'm moving away, so I'm forcing it to activate. All right, as a matter of fact, I'll come over here to the story chair. All right, so what it's doing is it's focusing on me, and the phase detection gets it mighty, mighty, mighty close. And then that last little woof comes in from contrast detection. So that's why that's called a hybrid focusing system. Canons, it would follow me along, and it would just turn on any pixel that it needs, or that it thinks it needs, in you know, where it's assuming you're going to go, and is turning on those pixels to be also used for autofocus. So that it's turning on and off pixels. That's why sometimes the Canon, to me, dual pixel autofocus seems a little slower than the Sony. Sony's on full time, full throttle. All right, and what it does is those photodiodes that are in there for focus, it's making it up like it was a dead pixel and pretending and filling in by what it needs, kind of like what JPEG does. So that's it. That's the difference between the Canon dual pixel autofocus, the Sony, and the Panasonic. So you've got three different types of focus systems. Dual pixel, where each pixel is capable of being called into service to work for the focus unit, or put back to work for the light gathering unit. Then you've got the Sony, which is, it's got embedded focus points. The Fuji has that also. Who else? Nikon has that also. They've embedded these focus receptors into the sensor. And then you've got Panasonic, which doesn't touch the sensor at all. Every single pixel records light. That's all it does. And then the software inside of the camera does the focusing through contrast autofocus. And I didn't explain what contrast. Do you need me to do that? Contrast autofocus is the most accurate out of all of them. However, once it gets into the area, it can't tell which way to move to focus properly. It doesn't know whether to move the camera is front focused or if the camera is back focused. So what it does is it rocks it. It rocks that focus motor until it gets more, bing. Okay, so that's what we're seeing, and we're calling it pulsing. It's rocking the focus motor, all right? And the more it does it, the more we see it. So that's it. That's what we got today. Did I do the right whites? In the link down below, if you care. Okay, I will write white color balance with that there. Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida. Bye. Go away.
You have just watched another Peter Gregg video. Something warm, human, and wonderful happens when you watch Peter Gregg. Thank you for watching. Description of all equipment used in this video plus any notes Peter took while filming are always placed in the description box, show more box, or down arrow thingy next to the title on mobile apps. Duly noted.